Hi,
I am Dr. Isha Prasad Bhagwat. Call me Isha.
Isha.
I am the Director of Program Operations at WaterAid India. WaterAid is an international charity working to provide access to safe water and sanitation to the world's poor and marginalized. It was set up in 1981 in London, UK. And ever since, it has been working in some of the most backward villages and urban areas of Africa, Asia and the Far East. In Asia, WaterAid works in India, Nepal, Pakistan and Bangladesh. The India operation started in around 18 years back in 1991. And it started in a small town in the south of India called Trichy. But over the past 18 years, we have expanded now. We have a country office in Delhi and we have 4 regional offices. And through this, and with a team of 50 leaders, as we call them, in water and sanitation, we work across 10 states of India. We work primarily with civil society organizations, build up the capacity to work with the poor and marginalized in the areas of water, sanitation and hygiene. We also advocate very freely and actively with the government of India and with the state governments to make sure that the available funds are, you know, really directed towards the poor and the marginalized. And we also try to mainstream water and sanitation into the whole development framework. That is a 3-pronged approach that WaterAid India has adopted. And through around 50 civil society partners, we are covering something like 70 districts across 10 states, more than 3,500 villages and 25 cities.
Can you tell me about a specific project that we talked about yesterday?
Yes. Yes, Marianne. I want to talk about 2 things. One is a success project in some of the worst drought-affected villages of central India, and a success story with community-managed toilets in urban scenarios of India. You know, when you look at the Indian subcontinent, the general picture that one gets is plenty of rivers, a decent monsoon, and then, you know, the Himalayas with a lot of glaciers and so on and so forth. So why should India be a water-scarce economy? But over the past several years, there are some parts of central India, which is called the Bundelkhand region, across 2 states, something like 7 districts, which have been affected by a series of droughts. 7-year drought. Drought was always known in this region, and India, being an ancient civilization, ancient communities, earlier civilizations, had adopted a system of, you know, tanks, village tanks, so that, you know, water could be harvested and, you know, used during the drought period. Over a period of time, these tanks degenerated. Over the past 600 years that we have documented, history says that the tanks degenerated, people lost interest, and the advent of modern technology worsened it. And the modern technology that came into the picture was drilling boreholes. It's extremely easy now. Over the past 30 years, thousands and thousands of boreholes have been drilled in this particular area, tapping that, you know, very small aquifers that we had of water. This area is called the Deccan Plateau. It's hard rock. There's very little water which goes into the aquifers despite good rainfalls. So then what happens is, the, you know, village water sources started drying up. And in many, many areas we have seen, because of the disturbance of the geohydrological structure, we have diseases like fluorosis coming into the picture there. So one is dry boreholes. Wherever there is water, fluorides contaminate the water, so people started getting affected. Now, in this particular region, WaterAid started working around 3 years back. And what we have done is revitalized the local traditional tanks there. We have made sure that, you know, whatever little rainfall falls is captured there and then. So in dry streams, dry rivulets, which are seasonal rivulets, we built something called check dams, so that the flow of water could be stopped there and then percolates into the ground, into the aquifers. We also made sure that the dry bores were converted into rainwater harvesting bores. So the village, you know, water, wherever it was drained off, goes into these particular bores, so it is harvested there. Whoever had a good building there, a concrete structure, the school building or the, let us say, the local government building, we started doing rainwater harvesting from the roofs. So all, whatever little rainfall was falling, we made sure that it really fell into the ground. So it's an oasis of peace in these villages where we are working. People have migrated from other areas because of, you know, problems of water. there's a water distress there. But in our villages, there is drinking water available and water available at least for the livestock. Agriculture may be affected because we don't have so much rainfall there. But the drinking water is definitely available for these people. So migration, if at all, is not of the entire family. It is of the heads of the household going outside for other things. But the families remain behind because of this. Now this is something that we have started advocating with all the villages in the nearby area and with the governments to make sure that whatever funding is available for such large-scale watershed programs is directed to these villages so that, you know, the area is revitalized.
What is the secret behind the success?
The secret behind the success is good rainwater harvesting. The simple technology which convinced the people that whatever little rainfall falls can be done there. The community was involved from the very beginning. We showed them that the old civilization, ancient civilization, survived in this area because of rainwater harvesting. So once they realized the value of whatever rainfall falls, it has to be stopped there and then. I think the communities realized. I mean, when they saw the success in a few villages, it has totally started scaling back.
And how will you continue?
Well, Marianne, we have demonstrated in these villages. As I said, WaterAid's three-pronged approach. One is, of course, service delivery, making sure that the people get rights. People access their rights to safe water sanitation. In this case, we demonstrated the possibilities there. Now we are actively lobbying along with the civil society organizations, with the local government and with the state government to see that available funds are directed towards this. Instead of drilling more bore wells, use the fund available to make sure rainwater harvesting structures are there.
Thank you.